concert with our concert band and jazz ensemble. We have our short presentation from our concert band, and you'll then a big part of this spring has been our composition unit, and Mrs. Catania will explain that piece of it and how it fits in. And then you'll hear from our jazz ensemble as well tonight. Our focus this semester has really been on individual skill development in a different way. We broke our brass and percussionists into a group and our woodwinds into a group, and Mrs. Catania and I kind of divided and conquered. And what we were working on is rhythmic independence, so that all the students are reading their own parts, and the music that we selected required a lot more individual independence as it split the section into more diverse voicings. So that, hopefully you notice, and as well as the maturity of sound that has developed since January to now. So we're really excited about what this group is doing. This next piece is a good example of things I just talked about. This is Impossible Machine.
Thank you. QR codes linked to student compositions. So one of the things that we did during our time period where we typically are rehearsing and working towards solo ensemble is we did a creation unit where we worked on composition standards. And the students did all sorts of different varieties of types of compositions where they would compose for groups, they would use digital software called Noteflight, some used Finale, some used coding and did Sonic Pi, and they used the actual coding to create music, and so you'll see a few of those or hear a few of those if you actually pop on here and check it out. Just don't during the concert, that might be distracting. So what you'll see is student work, some hand wrote, and that was okay too. The students were asked and given some deadlines, and they were told to compose an eight-measure melody, and we would work through a couple of the ideas and talk about composition, but mostly this is really their own work. So what you see is kind of budding composers, and hopefully you'll spend a little time listening or seeing some of the compositions, because there's just a great variety there. If your students isn't on here, just ask to see their work on their computer. It just meant that they probably couldn't get the URL to us in time. So it didn't mean that they didn't necessarily do it. They couldn't do that too. So our final piece of the concert is a piece called Ancient Aran Dance. And this is a really great one to work on because it provides the students this knowledge of tons of different notes chromatically, so all the notes of the scale, in different ways. So it pushes them technically as well as pushing them musically. So I hope you enjoy this final piece before we see Jazz 2 on stage.
Thank you.
playing four tunes for you this evening. The first tune we're going to play for you is called Monin, and it's by the pianist Bobby Timmons. This tune was originally played by the group Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. We're going to be playing our version today. It's going to feature Sarah on alto, Sam on trombone, and Alyssa on trumpet. This is Monin by Bobby Timmons. The next tune that we're going to play for you was originally written by Charlie Parker, the great alto saxophonist, probably one of the greatest bebop players that ever lived. And this song is going to be featuring, Alyssa has a pretty big solo in it, and Alex is also going to be featured on tenor saxophone. This is Yardbird Suite. Thank you.
The next tune we're going to play is called 20 Nickels, and this song is actually dedicated to Clark Terry, who's a phenomenal trumpet player who lived down in the Chicago area for many years. He's a pretty unique character, too. He could actually play his trumpet upside down, and if you go on YouTube, you can actually look up Clark Terry, and you can see videos of him playing his trumpet upside down with the bells, and the other way, too. He's a really cool musician. So this tune is called 20 Nickels, otherwise known as a dollar. And it's going to feature Caitlin on center saxophone, and Jerry's going to take a trumpet solo too. So this is 20 Nickels. The last thing we're going to play for you is Watermelon Man. And if you enjoy some of the music that you're hearing tonight, or you just want to have a really good time, on this Sunday, so coming up in just a few days, Jazz Ensemble 1, which is our premier jazz ensemble at Kettle Grand High School, is going to be performing at the Delafield Brewhouse, along with the All-Star Super Band, which is a big band of professional musicians from Milwaukee. I'm very fortunate to be able to be part of that group. But we're going to be starting at 6 o'clock at the Delafield Brew House, and we'll play till probably about 8:30 or so. We'll have the professional band, we'll do a set, The Jazz 1 students will do a set, and then we're going to kind of combine and give the high school students a chance to sit in with the band, and it should be a lot of fun. So if you don't have anything on your calendar for Sunday night, please come on by. We'd love to have you. The last tune we're going to play for you is called Watermelon Man by Herbie Hancock, and it's almost that time of year where we can start eating watermelon again. Looking forward to that. We're going to be featuring Rhiannon on alto sax, and Nate is going to have a solo on baritone saxophone. It's Watermelon Man. Thank you. Drive safe. Have a wonderful night.